First update from the team in Chile here.
CIA veteran Mike Cole and conflict analyst Dr. Michael Livingston review the findings from the field team in Santiago, Chile, where the team has uncovered infrared video of a highly anomalous flying object that an analysis revealed is not from a known terrestrial source.
I've never seen anything like that.
I don't know what that is.
They're saying that it's nothing man-made, right?
That's what our analyst is telling us.
And that's a real powerful piece of evidence for us.
Yeah. Even better, there is an ATIP kind of program that Chile has, CIFA. They are actively still looking at this video in addition to other cases like this.
So much of the progress we've made in this investigation on this side has been from declassified ATIP files.
Yeah.
Lord knows what CIFA has on their end.
Getting into CIFA is not going to be easy. I mean, imagine if somebody from Chile walked up to the Pentagon and said, hey, I'd like to have access to some of your most secret files. We're probably not going to let them have access.
Look, as a team, we just got to shotgun this thing.
And hopefully they can get to what we need.
While the field team in Chile tries to gain unprecedented access to CIFA,
we got an update from Mexico.
Mike and Dr. Livingston focus their attention on the team in Rio Blanco, Mexico, where they have uncovered a pattern of UFO sightings clustered in a nearby jungle.
Sarah, nice to
They were able to find a local jungle expert, Venancio, in Rio Blanco. And Venancio is saying that there have been sightings in that jungle for centuries. He can get them to where those sightings are taking place.
This is something that he found, and he doesn't know what it is.
They also would really like our thoughts on this material substance that Venancio had, this star jelly. People are associating this around the world with the stars and have been doing so for centuries. This actually goes all the way back to the Middle Ages. But science has got multiple different explanations for it. One of the most common, they believe, is this actually is spawn jelly from frogs or toads.
What do you mean spawn jelly?
What it is where another animal has actually eaten female frog, and in doing so, all of the egg material that was in that frog is released at once in one spot in this jelly mass.
However skeptical we may be about this star jelly, we can't deny that Venancio found this in the same jungle where the sightings are all clustered. Let's take a look in the LAS and see what it has on the Rio Blanco jungle.
The team utilizes the link analysis software to search for video footage of UFOs within a 20-mile radius of the Rio Blanco jungle.
7 hits. Rio Blanco over here, UFO. Relevancy rating 88.
All right, take a look. This looks like cell phone video. I mean, that thing appears to be holding position.
Mira, ya se bajó más rápido, ¿ya viste?
That is weird.
Let's check out this Rio Blanco UFO V1 over here. FLIR video from the Air Force.
A las 7, a la misma altura.
What is that?
Whatever it is moving at high rates of speed.
Ahí van más. Van más, siguen más atrás. Y van a una velocidad, pero... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 en la pantalla.
Look how many there are.
Pero, a ver, busquen eso que viene atrás de nosotros.
Look at that thing that's coming
behind us, they're saying. These guys sound scared. There is something going on in the jungles of Rio Blanco.
Let's get the team on the ground and see what more they can pull out of that jungle.
We're going to start opening our way through the machete.
Nick and Sarah, along with local expert Venancio and their translator Marcia, embark on a 15-mile trek to the exact area where UFO sightings have reportedly been clustered for centuries.
Venancio, there's no trail here. How do you know your way? Is it just up the river?
¿Cómo es que conoce el camino también? Porque no hay un camino definido como tal. Simplemente sigue el río, ¿cómo?
Sí, simplemente es el río.
So with my military background, I'm paying attention to markers along the way, so if I need to, I can get out. And in a movement like this, you know, Venancio, he's a great man, but he's not the youngest of people. If he goes down, how are we getting him out? We don't have a stretcher. There's no easy access road. We can't call a bird to come pick us up. You know, we're not gonna do an aerial evac. So, you know, I'm just constantly like paying attention to where we are. Okay, what would be an easy way out? Oh, someone goes down here. Okay, backtrack like a kilometer and we can go up this ridgeline. Like, it's not just an easy walk through the jungle.
Is it going to be this dense the whole way?
Venancio.
Sí.
¿Va a ser así de denso todo el camino?
Sí.
Yes, it's going to be this way.
Okay.
Okay. Podemos pasar.
So we're going to go down.
Yes.
Oh, oh,
cuidado.
The terrain's pretty intense. It's thick jungle and steep in parts.
You just want to keep low center of gravity, so.
It's physics.
Yeah, right?
And I'm constantly trying not to trip over.
Oh yeah, this is better down here. There's like a little rock right here.
Okay.
Objetos acá, en esta zona.
It says that the UFOs were collected in this place.
Look at that.
The tribes of ancient civilizations lived in these ruins. It could be Totonacas, it could be Olmecas, it could be Mayas.
Are there carvings?
Sí, tiene grabados. Sí.
Yes.
Can we take a look?
Yeah, can we go in?
Vamos, sí, yeah. Están, vamos.
Con
cuidado para subir, está algo peligroso.
Just be careful because going up is very difficult and dangerous.
Okay.
Look at these down here. This is incredible. You can see all the engravings. I assume they were done by early humans a long time ago, dating back thousands of years. Look at this. I'm really excited. Venancio shows us these carvings. And it's incredible. This is part of our history as a species. These are carvings from centuries ago. Look at that. Look at this. There's been some erosion. I kind of dust off some dirt. And some of the things, I can't tell exactly what they are, but they look to be like shapes, like squares and triangles, almost a windmill created out of shapes as well. And it's truly fascinating because this is forms of communication from early humans who were potentially living there. This is incredible.
Yeah, look at that.
There's like a handprint there. To see something like that firsthand is just a privilege. Hopefully this will help with the investigation. Look at that. Look at this. There's a foot.
With these carvings, it's clear that these ruins, people were living here a very, very long time ago. Whoa.
This is so incredible.
It's crazy. Can you imagine? I wonder how far back these date.
Look at this. Look, that looks like a face. Look, see, shine it on that, look.
So I wonder what inspired them to carve what they carved. And here we have clearly elongated features.
See, it looks like possibly aliens.
If we have a record thousands of years old that depicts something like an alien face or form that dates back way into the human record, I mean, that is pretty compelling.
This just blows my mind.